Hi, I'm David Marquis, and I'm a Senior Product Manager at Equinix. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to the new changes for Service Profile Location Mapping for Fabric 2022.5. These new updates introduce changes to the way service providers on Fabric can add and remove ports or locations to a service profile, and finally create and map service regions to ports that have been added to the service profile. These changes are aimed at introducing an improved user experience when creating or editing a service profile for your organization. First, log into Equinix Fabric. Once you're logged in, go to My Company, then select Create a Service Profile. Under Layer 2 Service, select Create a Layer 2 Service. While creating a service profile, you will first provide a few initial details for the service to be offered. Note that there have been no changes introduced to this particular step as part of these updates. First, you will be required to provide a name and a description for the service. Then, you will select whether the service profile will be private or public, meaning it is available to any other Fabric participants. If you select public, Equinix will review and approve your service profile before it becomes available. For this example, we will create a private service profile. Additionally, I will add this particular user email to the permitted email addresses so that we can later on view the details of how customers would connect to the service profile. Optionally, you can select from any tags you want to associate to your service profile. Click Next to proceed to the next step. In the Location step is where you will find the new updates. When creating a new service profile, you must select the encapsulation type of the ports that will be associated to the service profile. The encapsulation type must be either .1Q or Q&Q, but cannot be both. Select the port encapsulation type. You will notice that the Add Ports button becomes available after selecting an encapsulation type. You can click on Add Ports, or alternatively, you can click on the center of the table to begin adding ports. Once you click on Add Ports, a drawer will appear from the right side of the screen with all of the ports available to you under your organization. Each row will show relevant information of the port, such as the specific IBX where the port is located, the metro or location, the port priority, and the bandwidth. Additionally, you can search for individual port names, you can filter based on metro locations, and you can also select from ports available under different organizations under your company structure on Fabric. Let's go ahead and select a few ports. Once you've selected all of the ports you want to add to the service profile, you can click Add Ports at the bottom of the drawer. This will add the ports to the service profile. You can now see that the ports are on the main page table. A summary of the total number of ports added to the service profile will be displayed at the bottom of the table. If the names of any ports that you have added to the service profile are longer than the column size, you can hover over the port name to view the full text. On the location page ports table, you can also use similar search and filter criteria to search from the available ports that you have added to the service profile. To remove one or more ports from the service profile, first select the ports that you want to remove. You will notice that the ellipsis button becomes available for selection. So you can click on the ellipsis button and select Remove Ports. The selected ports have now been removed from the service profile. To add any additional ports to the service profile, you can select Add Ports. You will notice that the ports that have already been added to the service profile on the main page are no longer available to select from in the drawer. Alternatively, you can cancel the operation. Finally, you can optionally create and map service regions to ports that have been added to the service profile. Service regions allow you to map ports and their associated metro locations on Fabric to regional offerings of your service. Customers connecting to your service profile on Fabric will be shown the metro and the service region combination when they select the C side of the connection. To add a service region to one or more ports, first select the ports you want to assign the service region to. Once selected, the Assign Service Region button becomes available. Click Assign Service Region. At the top of the drawer, you will see a collapsed summary of the ports you have selected from the service profile, along with basic information such as the IBX, the location, and any service regions that may have been added or assigned to these ports beforehand. Click on Add Service Region to create a new service region. You can provide any text to be displayed to your users so that they can identify your regional service offering. Click on Add. Additionally, you can create or continue creating any new regions that you may want to create. Finally, you can select from the service regions you have just created to assign them to the previously selected ports. Note that if any of the ports you have previously selected have read service regions assigned to them, they would be overridden by your current selection. Remember that Fabric users will see the metro location of the selected ports along with the service region you have created. Go ahead and click on Submit at the bottom of the drawer. The newly created service region is assigned to the ports, and customers will be able to see this new region along with the metro information when they're creating a connection against the service profile. Note that once you finalize creating or editing your service profile, any service regions that you have not assigned to any of the ports on the main page will become unavailable. In this case, if we were not to assign US East 2 to any ports, when we return to edit the service profile, you would have to recreate this service region. Just go ahead and cancel this operation. You can now proceed with the remaining details of the service profile. There have been no changes to the additional configuration options or steps in the service profile creation workflow. Once you're happy with the service profile configuration, click on Create a Service Profile. Remember that if your service profile is created under a public option, your service profile would be reviewed by Equinix and approved before it becomes publicly available. Once created, you can now check how your customers view your service profile offering when creating connections against it. Let's go ahead and do that. You can go and click on Create Connection. If your service profile is public and has been approved by Equinix, you can find it under Create a Connection to a Service Provider and find your organization and service profile. If your profile is public, private, like in our case, ensure your email address is added to the permitted email addresses as we had previously done so that you can view your profile. So let's go ahead and select my own assets. You can connect to assets to a service profile, create a connection. Now you can see the private service profile that was recently created. Go ahead and select create connection. Here, you can view how customers will connect to your service profile and any service region mappings you have configured on your service. At this point, you can introduce any other modifications or additional service regions as you are editing your service profile in the future. This completes the demonstration. Thank you for watching.